Good evening. What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Cousin Drew's Cooking Show, episode 44. We're doing a pistachio crusted halibut for you guys tonight. How's everybody doing? Happy Tuesday. What's going on, guys? Hey, FIFA, what's going on, man? You watching those World Cup games or what? How's it going, Chef Dog? Welcome back. I'm happy to be here with you guys. I feel like it's been for freaking ever. It's been since June 6th, since the last cooking stream. Happy to be back. Happy to be with you guys. Had to get some things squared away, you know what I'm saying? How's everyone doing tonight? Happy to see you guys in chat. Thanks so much for stopping by, guys. We're going to have a great episode coming your way. Pistachio-crusted halibut that we're going to be serving with this delicious, delicious purple braised cabbage recipe that I learned in culinary school that I fell in love with. I do not like cabbage that much at all. That's why I always do it like my coleslaw, like things like that. But I use cabbage. I got to do it in a way that, you know, completely changes it for me and makes me enjoy it. And this is one of those recipes. Absolutely delicious. Super excited to show you guys how to do it. Super simple, super easy. A matter of gathering a couple ingredients here and there, you know what I'm saying? But it's no big deal. And then we're going to be doing, you remember we did the episode with the white yams, right? They're like the white sweet potatoes. We roasted them in the oven. Tonight, we're going to make a little mashed yam with it because I've never used that in mashed yam. I've done mashed sweet potato, but I'm curious to see how that was because it's a little bit toned down as far as the strong sweet flavor. So we'll sweeten it back up with a little bit of maple syrup. But it's going to be bomb because I've never done that before. And then we're going to be doing, I was like, damn, I was thinking about it. I was like, I don't got a sauce. Like, what am I going to do for sauce? And I was like, you know what? Last time we did a fish, we did the traditional beurre blanc for you guys. So tonight we're going to do a beurre rouge. Basically, same thing, blanc white, rouge red. We're going to be doing a red wine butter sauce. Real traditional, real easy. You know what I'm saying? Like the wife chef coat? Well, I'm glad you like it. This is my North Ranch chef coat when I was working over at the country club. And then I got the new hat on. This is my boy Dylan. You know, him and his family own Ito Farms, and they do all the strawberries in our area. Super delicious strawberries, like candy. He hooked it up with a hat, so I was like, shit, might as well represent, you know what I'm saying? Who am I cooking for tonight? Just cooking for my girlfriend tonight. Kaylee's got a plate coming her way. But other than that, yeah, just us two. We have Daisy in the house. Get some Daisy cams up for you guys. Feel like it's been way too freaking long. So how you guys doing? What's going on, chat? So look, we're going to go ahead and get started, guys. We're going to get our yams boiling so we can get that ready for the mash. We got to get this freaking cabbage going. The cabbage takes probably the longest as far as everything goes. It's a matter of getting the bacon cooked off, right? After we get the bacon cooked off, we got to get the cabbage thrown in there with the stock. We got to get that going. I have it all written out. It's the same recipe I got from culinary school. So, you know, I'm excited to get it going. It's got cabbage, bacon, red onion, sugar. We're going to use chicken stock. I got some Granny Smith apple, whole clove, whole allspice, cinnamon stick. I'm going to use some apple cider vinegar. Last time I used it, I did red wine vinegar, but I'm going to change it up a little apple. A little more tangy. A cup of red wine. We got a delicious Pinot we're going to crack open, and then a little salt and pepper, you know what I'm saying? So super simple, super easy. Hey, Kaylee coming through, gifting a sub to Chef Dog. Welcome back to the family tree, Chef Dog, my guy. What's going on? There are those emotes. That's what I like to see, baby. Thanks for the sub, man. I appreciate it. Thanks, Kaylee. I appreciate it, babe. Welcome, welcome. All right, so look, we got to get a couple things squared away. We got to get this bacon chopped up, start cooking that down, get our cabbage going. Then we're going to get our yams while the bacon's going. We're going to get our yams chopped up, thrown in the water, get that going, and then we'll move along. The halibut, super simple, super easy. We're going to start it on the stovetop after we crust it just to get the bottom kind of going, get the coagulation cracking, and then we're going to finish it off in the oven, let it do its thing, get a lot of flavor into it. What's going on, Apesman? How you doing? Welcome, welcome. Thanks for pouring in, guys. I appreciate it. Welcome, everybody. So let's go ahead. We're going to grab our bacon. Another cutting board. Cut open our bacon. Get that thick cut. Let's grab our yams, because we're going to be getting to those next. We need to grab our little peeler. All right, so let's get our bacon cracked open, guys. So how's everyone doing? Happy Tuesday. What are you guys having for dinner? Anyone eating right now? You guys cooking? Ordering in? What's going on with you guys? FIFA champ, how's your day, man? Welcome back. Happy to see you in here. Appreciate you stopping by like that. Alright. So, let's get our bacon. ready to be chopped. We'll do like three strips. I like a lot of bacon in this recipe. A lot of bacon. Okay. So we got our bacon strips lined up. We're going to cut these into little lardons. Alright. So let's get our lardon slices down. Sharp knife helps with bacon. You don't pull it and tear it. You can get these nice, you know, consistent slices, right? Keep them all the same size. Consistency is key. I'm eating cereal with almonds right now. I love almonds and I love cereal. Sounds delicious. I had the best egg sandwich of my life. Abesman, I saw that. It looked delicious. The picture looked great. I had to take off at the end of the episode, but I did get to see how it looked on Instagram, and I saw the steak when it came off and it looked delicious. So it looks like you had a great dinner. Miss you too, Jackie. You got to come up for an ep. We're gonna do an episode. Jackie approached me and reminded me we're gonna be doing an episode where Jackie comes down, and you know, Jackie cooks, right? Jackie recreates a lot of the recipes. She actually cooked the tri-tip and the barbecue sauce again this weekend. She sent me a Snapchat. You know, she's always getting down. But Jackie's going to come out, and we're going to do an episode where basically she cooks for you guys, and I'm going to guide her the entire way along. So that's going to be super, super cool. Super cool. Kale, you cut them into lard dogs, huh? Hey, that was good. That was creative, Kaylee. The lard dog. Jesus. All right, let me get the knife sanitized after cutting the raw pork. All right, let's get our pot heated up for our lardons. So how I do like my bacon is I like to, when I cut them in lardons like this, I like to get the pot nice and hot, get the bacon in there, and then turn it down, kind of let the fat start to render, and then once you cool it and let it go at a low temp, it tends to do a little bit better like that. Instead of starting it on super low, it takes a little longer. All right, so we're going to peel our white yams. I've never had a white yam mash before. I'm super excited. I think it's going to be delicious. We're going to use some good spices in it that we will break out later. That's really going to complement it well, add some good texture and good tones to it. All right, it's got one with the white yams cleaned up all nicely. How you doing, Mama? How was your day? Didn't talk to you today. Usually we talk in the morning or something. But you just ignored your child all day. It's cool. I'll remember that. Just kidding. Alright. Okay. Got them all peeled up. Trash open. So we're going to get some of these excess crumbs out the way. Alright, so I'm sure pot's more than hot enough with the bacon. You can tell by the sizzle. So I turned it down to like a low temp. I'm going to go ahead and wash my hand, wash this cutting board off real quick. So bacon's in, getting a nice sizzle, so I have the pot nice and hot. And we're going to get it all spread out. Hit it with a little bit of oil. Oh, not the cap, just the oil. Get a little bit of excess fat to get it going. It's going to render out plenty of its own, but I just kind of like to get it going in it. I feel like it kind of speeds up the process a little bit. Bone-in New York strip taken off the bone. Delicious cut. Absolutely delicious. Hey, Kaylee coming through with a 6 month resub. Thanks, babe. I appreciate it. 6 months. It's crazy. I'm super hungry now. There's a plate for me, too. Hey, FIFA, come to Cali. Come to the area. We'll get a scheduled dish for you, you know what I'm saying? Alright, so. Bacon is going to start rendering out. We're going to keep its fat to cook down the onion and everything. So we're just going to let this do its thing. Move the heat up just a tad bit. We're going to get our yams cut up so we can get it in our pot of water. Alright. Here. Oh, you live in Cali. That's right, that's right, that's right. Whereabouts again? Now I'm remembering. Our last time we had that conversation. I just don't remember. Whereabouts. So yeah, be careful when you're cutting into your yam. I try to find like the most solid part to cut into, but it will definitely help having a sharper knife. Santa Ana. It wasn't Disney. It was a separate company, Chef Dog, from what I understand, after Kaylee explained everything to me. So I was very unsure. Right. So we're gonna give those a nice cut. We're going to discard any of the smaller ends that kind of just dissolve and turn to mush anyway. So we're going to kind of cut those off and get them out the way. Those little bits. So everything stays consistent, right? Consistency is key in cooking. The more consistent you are, the better the meal is going to turn out. Alright, so let's discard our ends here. No need. Check back in on our bacon. So see all the fat starting to render out now? Yeah, we're getting a lot of fat. Probably a teaspoon every minute or so coming out. Let me smell of some bacon. Let's get that fan cranked up. It's nice and hot in here. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and discard a little water. Maxi! What's going on, baby? How you doing, Maximilius? Welcome, welcome. Happy to see you in here. I feel like J.O. doesn't reckon. I feel you, dog. He's blown up. You know what I'm saying? It's not the same as it used to be, but like I said what up to him yesterday, and he always still says what up, but yeah, I know what you mean, bro. But that's what happens when you blow up, man. I'm happy for him, though. Dude's killing it. Absolutely killing it. It's no big deal. You're still there supporting, you know what I'm saying? It's all important. Alright, so we got our yams on a pot in the back. We're just going to get those going. Get them cooked down, softened about that pork tender, right? Get back in on our bacon. Alright, so I'm starting to see some more color on the bacon. So that means we're at a good temperature. It's going to start crisping up the bacon a little bit for us. So we need to get an onion sliced up. Apple we're going to do right before because apple oxidizes like a banana when you peel open a banana and it sits. Or a potato, or you know what I'm saying? So we're gonna chill and wait on that. Since he joined FaZe, but he's a good guy. Yeah, he is. Crispy bacon, baby, you know what I'm saying? So let's get our onion sliced up. I get that bacon put away in a sec. Just gonna kind of wash the knife off after cutting into the yam. Yeah, the aroma of the bacon, I'm telling you. Alright, so we're going to do like a nice thin slice so it kind of blends in with the cabbage, the onion itself. We're gonna let it blend in, right? So we're gonna do nice long slices, but we're gonna keep the cabbage long once we shred it. All right, so we're just gonna do a basic saute cut on our onion. There. Now on our other red onion. Alright. Red onion is chopped up. That'll get cooked down once our bacon's ready to rot. Swing back over there for you guys. Alright, see how much fat's pouring out? Now we're really crisping up our bacon. Oh yeah. The bacon's crisping up good. We're gonna let that go. And we're gonna take some of the oil out. Take the bacon out. Leave a little bit of the oil in. And we're gonna go ahead and, you know, kind of cook everything together. Let those flavors really, really go into the onion. Clean the knife. Always cleaning the knife. Oh, good news, Drew. By ends of summer, my job looking at me possible manager. They might be opening a second restaurant down western in Key West. Awesome, Chef Dog. That's great news, man. Congratulations. That's great. Exactly. Hard work always pays off, man. Always, always. Good shit. Happy for you, Chef Dog. Very, very happy for you. Alright, that's almost done. Let's grab, so we can go ahead and we can do a couple things. We can get our crust. Yeah, we gotta get our crust ready. So we gotta get our pistachios chopped. We're gonna add a little cornmeal and parsley to it. We gotta get the parsley chopped. And then we gotta get the Dijon mix. We're gonna do a little bit of lemon zest into the Dijon. That's gonna hold the pistachio crust on. All right, bacon's looking good. We're gonna do it on here. We're gonna drain our bacon fat into here. Catch our bacon. Save it. Right. All right. So we're gonna reserve our bacon. Grab a paper towel. So put that on a paper towel for now. We got our nice crisp bacon. We got our hot bacon fat right here. Okay, so now we need to get our onion cooked down. So what we're gonna do, guys, we're gonna grab a little bit of our bacon fat. We're gonna add it back in. Okay, a tad bit. Grab some onion. Get that thrown in there. Let that bacon fat really cook into the onion. We're gonna throw some sugar on there. It's gonna be kind of sweeten it up so it's not so pungent with all the acid that's gonna be in there with the red wine and everything. So I'm gonna grab sugar. Grab like a teaspoon of sugar. Hey, Telepath coming through with 100 biddies. Thank you so much, Telepath. I'm gonna do a heaping teaspoon of sugar in there. Thank you so much, Telepath, and welcome back. Appreciate the bits. Hope you're having a great Tuesday. Thank you so much for stopping by. Pop's coming through with the 6-month reset. Thank you so much, Dad. Thank you. Man, you guys are firing away with all these things. Thank you so much, guys. All right, so let's check back in. So we got our reserved bacon fat, coating our onions, cooking them up. We're gonna add probably a little more fat. We just hit it with some sugar. Add a little more fat in there. Can never have too much fat. So we're gonna let our onions kind of cook down. Not quite at a boil there yet, so those are still working. So we got our bacon here, guys, right? Nice crisped up bacon. We're gonna reserve that for the end time. So we'll set that to the side. Oh shoot, Pop's dropping 1,000 bits, activating the new football emotes for you guys for a little bit. That's awesome. What's going on, Dad? Thanks for stopping by.
Alright. So let's let those cook down. Let's grab our pistachios. Oh, let's get our bacon for the fridge. Wrap it up later.
So we're gonna get pistachios chopped up. Thanks so much for the bits, guys. I appreciate it very much. Seriously, thank you so much, guys. All your guys' support's super generous. The subs, everything. Thank you. Man. Sharp knife will fix everything. There we go. Now those onions are really starting to... All right. Yeah, the football emotes are cool. You'll find out. It's just stuff for the stream, Chef Dog. You'll find out in a couple weeks or so. It's just stream stuff. I'm not quite ready to announce it yet. When the timing's right, you'll be getting your stream news. All right, so we're gonna just do like a nice gentle chop at first, right? So what happens if you start chopping too hard at the beginning is they're gonna start shooting all over the place. I'll change the camera in a sec. All right. So you do like a nice light chop at first, right? Kind of work them in a little bit. And then once you get them kind of crushed, then you can kind of speed up the mincing, and they're not going to fly around everywhere. So we need enough to coat with 2 halibuts, right? 2 decent sized fillet of halibut. Are those pistachios? Yes, it's pistachios. We're going to be combining with a little bit of cornmeal and Italian parsley.
Onions are cooking down very nicely. We're going to get our cabbage out in a set. The yams have finally come to a nice boil.
We're going to get this finished mincing, and then we're gonna get our cabbage sliced and get that ready to get thrown in. All right, so we got a nice mince here in our pistachio, as you guys see. Grab a bowl-ski. All right, get our pistachio. Throw in our bowl, hit it with our mix in a sec. Brown Bacon's coming through with a Twitch Prime? Well, thank you very much, Brown Bacon's. Welcome to the family tree. Thanks so much for stopping by. Thank you for the sub. Everybody, go ahead and welcome Brown Bacon's. Thank you so much, man. Wow. Incredible. I appreciate the sub, man. Let's get some Cousin Drew emotes, all my subs in chat for our boy Browns Bacon. Welcome to the family tree, my guy.
Alright, cabbage. Ugh. Alright, let's try not to break anything. We got the fridge stocked up right now, so there's a lot going on in that bit. I'm gonna use the other cutting board that I washed. Because this purple shit gets everywhere. Probably just gonna do half the head of cabbage. We're not gonna need the rest. So when you're breaking down cabbage, you like to quarter it up, guys, right? Quarter it right down this vein right here. Okay? And then what you can do is you got this big bitter inner middle piece. So when you quarter it, you expose it. And then you just slice that bitch out. And now it ain't there. Okay? Bye-bye, middle vein. I'm going to peel off a couple of the outer leaves. So they tend to be a little bit beat up. A little beat. Scoop off some of this little droppings. All right, let's rotate over to our bacon real quick, y'all. All right, we'll turn this down. Onions are cooked in really nicely. Once we add our cabbage in, we're gonna get a fork real quick. Test out the sweet potatoes. Pretty hard still.
All right. FIFA champ. Hey! Cooking with Che coming through with the raid with 16 viewers. Thank you so much for the raid. I appreciate it. Welcome, everybody. Thank you so much, Che. Wow. Incredible. Thank you so much. Welcome, 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 everybody. Welcome. How's everybody doing? Uncle Stinky, how you doing today? Thank you so much, guys, for stopping by. Welcome, everybody. Holy shit. All right. We're just getting our cabbage broken down for our braised cabbage, everybody. I'll say some more welcomes in just a second, guys. Let's go ahead and break this cabbage down real quick. Thank you so much for the host again. I truly appreciate it very much. Wow. Coming through with the biddies? Wow. Professional OPs dropped a follow. Thank you very much for the follow. Uncle Stinky, thank you so much for the 400 biddies. Welcome, everybody. Thank you so much. Welcome, everybody. All the family tree members in chat, go ahead and welcome all our newcomers, guys. Huh?
All right. Let's get our cabbage thrown in to our pot. As much of it as we can get in there. It tends to break down a lot. So, you know, we can kind of get it. We can get it pretty stuffed in, you know what I'm saying? Okay. All right, so we'll keep our reserves off to the side. So we got our pot covered up with our braised cabbage right here. We got our onions mixed in at the bottom. We're gonna go ahead and kind of give them a little toss around, right? Kind of get that bacon fat spread throughout the cabbage real quick. Okay, we're just gonna turn that up a little bit. Let it do its thing.
Wow, thank you so much, guys, for stopping by. I appreciate it. Thank you so much for the 10 bits, X. I'm going to call you X. I don't know how to say your name. The Dark Prince, CA. Thank you very much for the follow. Welcome, everybody. Thank you so much, guys, for dropping by. And again, thank you so much for the raid, Cooking with Che. I appreciate it so, so much. Thank you very, very much. So tonight, guys, we've got a pistachio-crusted halibut that we're making with a braised red cabbage recipe that I learned back in culinary school. And we're going to be serving that with a white yam mash that we're going to sweeten up with a little bit of maple syrup, you know what I'm saying? I'm glad I got to catch it. Well, I'm glad you did, too. I seriously appreciate it. Thank you so much. It's incredible. All right, so now that we transferred it over, I turned up the heat, starting to let that cabbage kind of cook down a little bit before we throw in our stock. So what we're going to do while we got this going before we add our liquid is we're going to
go ahead. We're gonna get our apple sliced up real quick. We're not gonna shave off the skin. We're gonna leave it on. We're gonna cut our apple down right around the core. We're gonna go ahead and we're gonna do some nice apple slices. We got some good Granny Smiths right here. Right, some long slices of apple. Right. We got some broken down apple. We want to throw in there to kind of sweeten up our cabbage dish. We're going to have bacon, apple. We're going to go ahead and add a couple seasonings in there as well. Right. We made some, not that great, some sea salt brownies. Yum, sounds delicious. I love some sea salt brownies, that's for damn sure. Thank you so much, guys, again, for stopping by. I appreciate it. All right, so we got to get the rest of our crust made. We're going to let that do its thing. Let's grab a couple of our seasonings we're going to add in there. We're going to throw a whole cinnamon stick in there, guys. Come on. All right, so we're throwing one cinnamon stick in there. Along with the three whole cloves. Three whole cloves. Thrown in there. And then we're gonna add some whole allspice in there. It's gonna add some delicious depth of flavor to these to this cabbage dish, I'm telling you. So we're gonna add like four whole cloves in there as well. These are really powerful ingredients, guys. You're gonna mess around with either clove or allspice, or especially cinnamon sticks themselves. Super potent ingredients, so less is more. Definitely add a little bit and work your way up, because man, oh man, that shit gets pretty damn pungent. We're gonna add a little salt. Kind of mix everything around in there, guys. We really want these flavors to blend and come together. All right, so next, we're gonna go ahead and add our chicken stock into the braise. And we're gonna go ahead and add our red wine and our vinegar a little bit later on. We're gonna start the braise for about 30 minutes here with chicken stock. Okay. We're gonna let that cook down on a high temp. And then we're gonna go ahead and add the rest of the other stuff later. I need to find my top. All right, top goes on. We're good with that. You guys wanna do a daisy cam so everybody can see the girl? All right, Kaylee, go ahead and send Daisy on out. Burson, how many cameras do you have? I got 1, 2, 3, and 4 you're gonna see for daisy cam. Come here, Daisy. You went to Le Cordon Bleu, now I feel like an amateur. Yes, I did go to Le Cordon Bleu. Daisy, come on. Wanna say hi to everybody? Come on, baby girl. Come on. Say hi. Come here. Come on. Sit. Sit. Say hi to all our new friends. You say hi. Yeah. Tired, baby. Say hi to everybody. That's my girl Daisy, all you newcomers. Alright, checking on the yams. They're ready to rock. So we're going to go ahead and drain. Come on, Daisy. You can get out, baby. Good girl. Wait, you guys couldn't see her? What? Couldn't see her. Really? The heck? How weird. Camera ain't working. Here, we'll do it like this. Come here, Daisy. Wanna say hi to everybody? Come here, baby. Say hi. I don't know, that camera's not working. Sit. Sit down. Shake. You good girl? There's a baby. Sorry, guys. I don't know what's going on with the camera. It was working earlier, as far as I can see. That's the little Daisy girl for you. Let me just go ahead and whip this baby back down and around. Alright, so now we got our cutting board back in action, guys. Alright, we'll get to the bottom of that a little later. It's not showing the camera light on. Sometimes the camera has a little bit of issues. Alright, so we got our cabbage braising. So we're going to break down that cabbage and pull all the flavor in, you know what I'm saying? So that's my baby Daisy, guys, for all you newcomers. She's got her own little cam set up. So we need to drain our white yams, guys. I got my my sink strainer right here that I let stretch out upon my sink. So much easier. Right. So it's a little bit hotter. Alright, so we're going to pour out our yams, let them kind of chill for a sec, and then we're going to steam them up a little bit. Aranya, how you doing? How you doing today? How weird. Yeah, the camera's not showing it on. Orani Aranika, thank you very much for the follow. I appreciate it. Uncle Stinky, how was your day? So good to see you. I remember you. All right, cabbage is going. Yams are going. We're going to whip those babies up in the mixer. So I got to whip out for you guys. Put this other half of the cabbage in the fridge. All right, and then we're going to whip out the KitchenAid. That's how we're going to whip up our sweet mash. We're going to get our crust finished up for you guys. And then we're going to get our halibut started. Halibuts won't take too long at all. Cabbage is going to take, you know, a little bit of time. We're really just waiting for the cabbage to kind of get started, you know what I'm saying? Thank you very much, guys, for stopping by. Still appreciate it. No Gmo. Yeah, Gmo's not going to be a part of the stream. He kind of bailed on you, but bailed on me and shit. So I'm not going to get too into detail. But yeah, guys, no more Gmo on the stream. So all right. So let's show you guys how our braise is cracking, right? You can smell the cinnamon coming out. You can smell how delicious all the flavors are in here. It's so bomb. So bomb. So we're gonna let those cook down. Let all that flavor come together. To really break down that cabbage, right? It's very smooth. Rocking Kingdom. How's it going, man? Thanks for stopping by. This, it's Japanese. I don't know how to pronounce it, you know, dead on, but it's Ryoshoku. Well, now you're a non-GMO. GMO free, right? How you doing, Professional Peace? Thanks for stopping by. Bad homemade sandwich for lunch, drinking now. Well, you know what I'm saying? How'd you mess up your sandwich? Looks much like a sushi knife. Yeah, you definitely could cut sushi with it. It's fine Japanese blade. All right, so let's get the rest of our crust made, guys. We gotta get that ready for our halibut, and we're gonna get those babies out. So we got our pistachios, right? That we got all crunched up right here. We're going to add a tablespoon of cornmeal. It's going to kind of solidify the crust, going to kind of bring it together. All right. So we got a tablespoon of cornmeal thrown in there. And then we're going to get some fresh Italian parsley to add into there, guys. Let me grab my little herb container. Alright, let's get some fresh Italian parsley we're going to throw in there. About a tablespoon or so of our fresh parsley. Alright. Stainless or carbon? It's stainless. Stainless steel. But I do have a whole set of my Japanese globals back here. I got the whole set. Like the whole basic set that it came with. Chef knife, shinoku, herring, veggie, bread. And I use those a lot. This is just like more or less my main chef knife, but I love my globals. They're a little lighter. This is just like the right weight
as far as cutting. I don't like too heavy of a knife, but I don't like too light of a knife for when I do like my prep work and stuff. So this knife is perfect. The Global Chef knife itself, it's a little bit too light for me. A little too light. All right, so we're just gonna get this nice and chopped up. Oh damn, what is that herb hydroponic called? That herb hydroponic called is, it's called the Gourmet Today. It's a herb, you know, holder. You put your herbs in there, a little water, and then it's got this vent thing up there, and it keeps your herbs fresh for like an insanely long amount of time. Like, it's crazy how long I've had the parsley in there. Like, shit lasts forever in that thing, I'm telling you. All right, so we got our tablespoon of that in there. We're gonna clean off the cutting board real quick. A little bit more of it in there. All right. Go ahead and rinse the knife off. So our yams have completely drained off. They're nice and tender right here. Still hot. We'll get those whipped up in a little bit. So we got our our breading made, our pistachio, cornmeal, and fresh Italian parsley. So we got that all mixed up. We're gonna crust our halibut fillets with that up. Before we crust our halibut fillets up with our mix, there's one important step we gotta take, guys. Nate Dio Dub coming through with a 6-month resub. What's going on, baby? And Cooking with Shay coming through. I'm going to call you Shay with 100 biddies. Thank you so much for the bits. Nate Dog, what's going on, baby? How you doing? You have to have a card or something? Are you talking about that good medical herb or what? All right, so one thing before we get our fillets, I'm going to pull them out right now for you guys, as a matter of fact. But one thing that we're going to do before... So your crust has to stick to something, you know what I'm saying? So the crust sticking is very important. Hold on, I'm just kind of double checking that. Okay, we're good. So I got my halibut. So we're going to make it stick with our Dijon mustard. We're going to use that as our base to our little rub. You just need a little bit to get thrown onto the top of the fish. But what I want to do to enhance this Dijon, to add just another depth of flavor, because we're all about flavor, right, guys? All about that depth of flavor in our dishes. So, by doing so, we're going to add a little bit of fresh lemon zest with the microplane. Let's check on our cabbage, guys. Kind of rotate it. It's all cooking down nicely. About 10 minutes, we're going to add our vinegar and our red wine. Let it kind of finish off the braise. All right, so we got our Dijon mustard, right? So we're going to grab our microplane, and we're going to get some fresh lemon zest in there. And it's just going to add, you know, that little bit of freshness, a little bit of lemony flavor to the fish. And you're not even going to have to, you don't even know where it came from. All right, so always go down on your microplane, never go up. If you're trying to pull something off the back like I just did, if you go up, you'll slice the shit out of your finger. Always go down, guys. Okay? As a matter of fact, use a utensil. Don't even do what I just did. That shit can be dangerous. All right. So we got our zest thrown in our Dijon. I'm gonna wash that off real quick, guys. Along with my hand. All right, so we're just gonna take a spoon. It's hot as hell in here, guys. I'm telling you, it's a hot day today. Have a fantastic rest of the stream. I'm going to finish cleaning up. Hope to catch you soon. Shay, thank you so much for stopping by. I appreciate the raid. Thank you so much. Thank you for the bits. Thanks for the support. Hope I'm gonna catch your stream next time as well. I appreciate you staying. Enjoy cleaning up. I understand what that's like. I don't got a dishwasher, so I spend a good hour or so, 30 minutes, depending. To an hour, depending on like what I cook that night. Sometimes it's easy, but there's times where dishes take forever, so I know what you're saying. So enjoy the rest of your night, man, cleaning up. Yeah, absolutely. That's pretty cool. I'm gonna have to steal some of your ideas. Absolutely, Burson. Whatever idea you want to see, man, check out the YouTube CousinDrew1339. There's a command for it. All my past episodes, guys, all you newcomers, are on the YouTube. Check me out on social media, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, everything. I got all my high-res pictures uploaded there for you guys, and like I said, all episodes are on YouTube, guys. Auntie Jen, what's going on? Thank you so much for stopping by. Godmother's favorite dish. Good to hear. Dark, what's going on, my guy? All right, so we got our Dijon. How you doing, Dark? So happy to see you, man. All right, so let's grab some wax paper. So good being back here with you guys, man. Seriously. All right. So we're going to get a little bit of wax paper for our Halibut. Let's break our halibut fillets out. How you doing, Dark? Thanks so much for stopping by, man. I appreciate it. Good to hear from you. I hope you're having a great day. And yeah, like I said, Burson, steal away, man. All right. So we got some thick, some real nice thick halibut fillets. Good size. They're nice and thick, right? They're not them skinny, long fillets. These are nice and juicy, thick pieces of halibut. Talking, look how chunky monkey that guy is right there. It's a good freaking size halibut. Wash the hand real quick. Let's give it a little rinse. Oh yeah, Burson. I gotta keep you on your toes. I gotta go to the store. Cousin Drew be back in 30 minutes. See you stream. FIFA will be here, baby. I'll see you then. All right. So this is what we're about to do, guys. We're gonna take our halibut fillets, right? We're gonna hit it with some salt and pep. Okay, season it up. Okay. Then we're gonna go again. Hi Jinx, how you doing? Thanks for stopping by the stream, man. Welcome, welcome. Burson, thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate it. Alright guys, so we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna spread our Dijon mustard with our fresh lemon zest amongst the top of the halibut. Right? She spread that shit out. Alright, so we're gonna lather the fillets up with our Dijon. That's our sticking agent for our breading, for our crusting, right? So I'm gonna get this Dijon out of here. Alright, next we're gonna add our crust on. Nice to see someone with training on here. Well, I appreciate that, Burson. Every Tuesday and Thursday, my man. I'm in 20 something guy who just started adulting and I need to learn how to basic stuff here. Well, hi Jinx, check into the YouTube, my guy. We got a cooking 101 episode that we did back probably 15-20 episodes ago. All the past episodes are on YouTube. Check them out. They got step by step. I got all my ingredient and recipes on there. You know what I'm saying? Learn some things, bro, and apply them. Just practice them. Cooking requires practice and consistency. Trial and error. Don't be mad when you mess up. You got to keep trying. All right, so we're going to crust these babies up with our pistachio, cornmeal, and fresh Italian parsley mix. Make sure you cover every bit of that halibut with it. Let's get to our other one. Has beautiful color with the green and the yellow, and from all the items they actually contain the same coloring, so it works out really well. All right, so we got our good crusting on there, and don't forget, guys, to check out my website as well, www.cousindrewscookingshow.com. You can catch the live stream on the website on the Cousin Drew Live tab as well. Can't communicate in chat, but if it's more convenient or Twitch isn't working or something like that for you, check the website. You can watch a stream through there as well. And you can kind of like do a little subscribing thing to the website, join the list, you know what I'm saying? Communicate with me through there. If you need to email me, you can email me through there, whatever you guys need. And don't forget, at the bottom of the page, guys, below the bit leaderboard, there is a suggestion box. Please leave any suggestions you guys may have as far as dishes, anything you want, throw in the suggestion box. It's there for you guys. Working a job I hate but got a raise when I tried to get my 2 weeks notice. Damn, Dark.
Trapped your ass with that raise, though. All right, so now that our stock is kind of cooking down, right, and we're getting to the point where we almost have no liquid, we're going to let it go just a tad bit longer, all right? We're going to let it go a little longer so that liquid's almost gone. Then we're going to go ahead and hit it with our red wine and our apple cider vinegar. So our halibut, guys, we got it crusted up. Let's go ahead and peek at that one more time. We got our crusted up halibut right here, looking real freaking good. Real, real good. Liking that. Still considering giving a notice anyways? Well, if you're miserable, man, you gotta change it up, you know what I'm saying? If you can, do it. You know, sometimes you gotta make the decision and take the hit to find and do something you love. Do something new. Don't stay miserable, man. You gotta bring some joy to your life. So we're gonna get our mixer out, guys, for our yams. Now that we got our that pushed out pretty good, right when we get these whipped up and start getting that going, we're gonna get our halibut thrown on and we'll finish the sauce off last. Sauce is super simple, super easy. Put that there for now. We can put that there. Let's grab. We need our whisk. Got the dough hook and the kneader in there. We're gonna go ahead and get our whisk tool. You know what I'm saying? So again, thanks so much for stopping by, guys. I appreciate it. If you're enjoying your time, go ahead and follow. If you guys have a Twitch Prime available, you know, if you want to spend it on your favorite cooking streamer, hit your boy up, you know what I'm saying? We are going to be doing a subscriber giveaway in the next week to come. I got to talk to Max. We're going to figure out our random generator to get our thing going. But we are doing a little giveaway next week, guys, so stay tuned, all you newcomers. It is a subscriber giveaway, though. So thanks again, guys. Appreciate it. And like I said, hit me up on social media. We're here every Tuesday and Thursday. Check out the website. Anything you guys need to talk about, anything you need to learn, any recipes, any hints, tips, anything you got like that, let me know, man. I'm here to help you out. All right, guys. All right. So let's get the mixer whipped out. Last time we used the mixer, we were making some pasta. Told by all the semolina flour that's left on there. You know what? I'm going to take that off. So we're going to go ahead, guys, and we're going to take our white yams that we had cooked down for our mash. We're going to throw those into our pot, okay? So we got our white yams thrown in there, okay? We're going to go ahead and we're going to hit them with a little bit of cream and butter to get them going. Start with the butter. I feel like when you start with butter, because it's still hot, it'll help break down the butter a little bit. And then I'm going to heat some cream up in the microwave to make sure it's hot. Because if you throw cold cream in there, it's going to cool the entire process down. And it's also not going to help your butter is not going to mix in as well. So hit it with the heavy cream that's hot, right? So let's get some butter. We'll do about half a stick to start. Okay. Throw some butter in there and we'll start whipping it. I would love to get a camera on the whip and mix, so I'm gonna work on trying to figure out a way to implement when we use the mixer to have a camera right up in the ship for you guys. So I'm gonna turn that on a low, kind of let it do its thing. I'm gonna grab some heavy cream and we're just gonna warm it up real quick in the microwave. Do like a third a cup. Might need a little bit more than that. Go like a fourth. All right, we're gonna check on our cabbage. Might be completely out of liquid at this point. Let's transfer over, guys. Yeah, so we're just at the bottom of our cabbage. The liquid is completely pretty much cooked out at this point. So what we're going to do is we're going to add a cup of our of our red wine. Spilled a little bit of cornmeal.
Alright, so we're gonna open our bottle of wine. We've got a 2016 Line 39 Pinot, a little bit on the cheaper side, but I have used it before, so I know that I do enjoy it for a cheap wine. Drain my battery. No worries, Jackie, it's all good. Thanks so much for coming back, Jack.
All right, so we're gonna do about a cup of red wine in there. Okay.
Delicious Pinot. Yeah.
It is good. Then we're gonna throw some apple cider vinegar.
My favorite type is the organic apple cider vinegar. It's one of my favorite brands. It's a good one.
We're gonna add about a third of a cup of apple cider vinegar in there. We're gonna let this braise out. We're gonna get our pan ready for our halibut. I'm gonna move this to the back side. We're gonna get our pan heated up for our halibuts.
For the halibut. Okay. We made a burger with 90-10, added a little lamb, some garlic. God, that sounds delicious. I love a nice blend. My dad's all about that dark. He's going to be all over that, I'll tell you. What are you doing, Jack? What do you got going on? Where'd you go to dinner at? You know what? We'll add our bacon at the end. I'm not worried about that right now.
So we got these whipped up. Let's grab our heavy cream. Now, these yams broke down pretty damn creamy already with the butter, which I'm pretty surprised about. But I'm not so surprised because the white yam is so much softer, not as firm as the normal orange sweet potato. Alright, I need to get a spatula so I can kind of push everything in, right? Should be good. We're gonna hit it with a little maple syrup at the end. Hot pan's hot, nice and hot for our halibut. We're gonna add some extra virgin. I have none in my little in my little oil thing. Forgot to refill it. We're gonna get a little amount of oil in there. That might have been a little too much. Nice hot oil in there. Take our fillets. Alright. Our sweet yams are looking delicious. The mash coming out great. I think it's at the consistency that I want. Oh, Dylan, I saw it. All right, so
we're gonna go ahead and hit the sweet yams with some salt. A little pep.
A little garlic powder, and where are you at? A little bit of ground allspice. Nice and garlicky, and just a little bit of allspice to add some depth of flavor to these bad boys. So we got a nice hot pan. I'm gonna go ahead and I turn the heat down just a tad bit to like a medium low. We're just gonna get it started on the pan, and then we're moving it into the oven to finish. We're just starting it on the stovetop, right? Let it finish in the oven. Some crow breasts, that sounds interesting. ASAP yams. Wow, looks so good, Drew. Thanks, Jackie. I appreciate that, cuzzo. All right, so we got that. Let's start mixing that together. Get all the seasonings combined. And then we need to grab our maple syrup. That real, real maple syrup. Toss a little bit of that maple syrup in that bit. Alright. We'll let this go a little bit longer on here, and then we're tossing that baby in the oven, you know what I'm saying? They're casting for the next Food Network star, are they? Ew. No talkie time. Alright, so we got our yams all mixed together, they're looking good. Alright, let's go ahead and pop our fish in the oven. We've got it on 375. We're gonna let it go till it's about tender. I'm guessing around 10 minutes or so. While this baby back here for you guys. Here we can move this back to the front. So our cabbage now is braising in the vinegar, right? So it's a lot more flavor being added to it. It's very pungent. It's got that red wine thrown in there. Now everything's really cooked down, right? Look at how much the cabbage has come down. So we're gonna let that finish off. Let it do its thing. We're gonna add our bacon back once the liquid drains out just a tad bit. We're gonna go ahead and get ready to make our brew sauce. What I want to do first is I want to get all this these yams thrown into this pot so we can keep them hot. So I'm going to go ahead and pull it off. We got them to a perfect creamy consistency. Let's go ahead and taste. Oh my god. Guys. Holy shit. Wow. If you hadn't had, you know what, we don't even need this one. We'll do another big one. If you haven't had, wow. If you hadn't had mashed white yams, that is absolutely incredible. This tastes absolutely incredible. That is, I'm like in shock actually right now how delicious that is. Wow. It's the first time I tried it. And I will definitely be back to doing it again, but in a different way. But damn, that is good. Dad, you got to try this. And guys, yams are a lot. Don't get me wrong. Potatoes are a vegetable, right? And it's not bad for you. When you try it, it is. But yams are actually healthier for you, right? So if you could eat a little more yam in your diet, you're doing yourself a little bit better. That's a good thing. All right, so we're just gonna let our yams chill in here, stay warm, not on a low temp. We'll just kind of toss it around. Cabbage is finishing up. What do we got next? Oh, our sauce. So we need to get some garlic chopped up. Side shoot on triple D, that'd be tight. Just puts them in a box of the freezer pack. I'll send you my address. I switched from regular potato to sweet potato for a while. Yeah, I mean, sweet potato is delicious. It's really good for you, too. All right, if I could ever get this garlic open. So, guys, we're doing a beurre rouge sauce. We did a beurre blanc sauce the last time we did fish. Now, a beurre rouge sauce is a red wine butter sauce. So, instead of the blanc, we're doing the rouge.
delicious sauce. So we got our cloves of garlic. Nice little mince. Now let's get them a little bit more chopped. So we're just going to get our garlic minced up nice and fine. Go ahead and mix that that white yam mash around. Second. Alright. Garlic's looking good.
Need to soak this real quick. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna rotate our yam mash. All right, our liquid's pretty much almost gone, and our braise, we got a little bit left in there. I'm gonna go ahead and add the bacon back in there, guys. Gonna add like a nice saltiness to it, as well as the bacon flavor, right? So we're gonna toss the bacon around in there. This should be finishing up right at the same time as the halibut. Let's move this back to the bat. Again, because we are gonna be using the front for our sauce. So we're going to heat up our pan for our sauce. We're going to get our garlic going. We're going to grab a little shallot. Shallot down. All right. We need just a little bit of shallot, nothing crazy here. Y'all bumping in chat tonight, huh? Love it. I love seeing you guys all here. Thank you so much, guys. The support, seriously. Feels good to be freaking back in action, baby. All right. A little bit of shallot. Okay, so these babies are gonna get cooked down in our pot. We got a little extra virgin going in there. We're gonna heat up the oil a little bit. Let's take a peek at our halibut. Wanna see how that's firming up real quick. Get an idea of where we're at here. All right, I still got some time. You can tell by the firmness on the sides. All right, so let's get our shallot thrown in, garlic thrown in. Now right off the bat, that aroma of the shallot and garlic sweating down together, one of the best things you could ever smell in the kitchen, I'll tell you that. It's a base for a lot of things, and it is for a reason, because of that frickin' smell. So now we gotta get a shit ton of butter out, which is why I bought more butter, because we're gonna be going through
good amount of it. Wash the knife off real quick. I have been considering trying to go on guys' Facebook and invite them on Twitter. That'd be cool. Yeah, Dark, we'll get another Daisy Cam going in a sec. We had one a little bit earlier, but yeah, I'll bring her out. Just give me a second. I gotta make sure I keep an eye on this real quick so it don't turn on me like it won't to. All right. So I sweated these babies down. We got a little bit of roasty goodness there. We're gonna hit it with our wine. All right. And then next, we need our fresh thyme. And then some peppercorns. So we're gonna get some sprigs of our fresh thyme. Come here, baby. We got our thyme thrown in there. And some peppercorns. Hold on. Let me grab my peppercorns. Put a couple peppercorns in there. Add some flavor. We're gonna let that wine reduce down nicely. Alright. I don't know why this camera don't work. I wonder if I nugget.
Look at that again.
No. It's weird. We'll have to do Daisy Cam on that one again. Alright, so let's get our butter. This one's warm, so it's not gonna slice as smooth as the other ones. So we're going to get our butter ready for our sauce. Includes a lot of butter. All right, let's check on our cabbage. See if the liquid's almost completely gone. Because once it is, it'll be time to turn it down to low. We got our yams staying nice and warm. Give it a nice little mix around, right? Don't want to ever let things sit on a flame for too long. You got to mix it. Very important. All right, let's check back on over here. Looks like we are out of liquid. Looking good. We're going straight down to low temp. Looking good. Our wine is pretty much reduced out. We're gonna add a little bit more before we throw our butter in. Add a little bit more in there while it kind of sits over. We're gonna season it up with some salt and pep. Some salt. Some fresh ground pepper. Pull that cinnamon stick out. Still some left in there somewhere. All right, we're gonna let that sit. We're gonna get ready to throw our butter in our pan in just a second. It is so hot in here. I gotta see if I can open the door real quick, guys. Alright, we got the door open. We got a little bit of air. It's hot as a mother in here. Alright, let's get our butter. Let's check our halibut one more time. For the one time, two time, for the two time. Alright. Yep. We're there. We're there, baby. We're perfect. Perfect, perfect. I'm going to take a little bit of butter. I'm going to throw it in this pan. Woo, there it is. just to kind of let these babies sit in a little bit of butter. Those are looking good.
Now our sauce is ready to rock and roll.
Excuse me. All right, so we're starting the emulsifying process here for our sauce. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and put this down while I cut the rest of this butter up. So everything's just about ready, ladies and gentlemen. We're right there on the end. I'm going to shake this around one more time before we slice. You got to keep that emulsification process going so it doesn't break. Throw it back on the heat for a second. Got to keep it on and off the heat. Keep the temp low, but not too low. Because then the butter will kind of get thick and harden up. We're just trying to get it on and off the heat. Okay. Some more butter in there. We're going to switch over for you. So we're doing a little bit of butter at a time. You see it gets that nice red tint from the red wine. I'm going to wash the hand off, get the butter off my hand. So if I was to leave it on the flame too long, the butter is just going to sit there and break. So we just want it to heat up a little bit, and we're going to take it off. We're going to do our thing. On and off the heat, baby. Yeah, fish spatulas are the best. They're so versatile. Damn. Dark's getting owned by Nightbot. All right. So what I'm going to do, guys, with that halibut, I got all that butter in there. Ooh. So I'm just gonna sprinkle a little butter over the top. Kind of a little bit of that butter flavor. Oh, am I even in the camera? I forgot that I moved the camera angle tonight a little lower to see how it looks. So I keep messing up my angles. Here's our halibut, guys. So I sprinkled a little butter over that. And we're just gonna let it chill. Kind of baste itself a little bit with that butter. Ooh. Almost left that on there too long. All right, more butter. A lot of butter in this, I'm telling you. It's a lot of butter, guys. You guys ready to see this plate up? It's gonna look bomb, baby. I'm excited for this one, guys. Let me tell you. Super, super excited. Rotate our yams. Oh, hot yam. Cabbage is straight chilling. We're gonna get our plates out, get ready to plate up, guys. Sauce is almost about there. Grab a couple plates. Ready to rock and roll. We are gonna strain the sauce out, by the way, so it'll be nice and silky. And we're gonna add some heavy cream to it real quick. So heavy cream you can add, and it's use it as a stabilizer to help it from breaking so easily. We're just gonna add just a little bit. And like I said, it's just a stabilizer. It adds a little bit of body and just keeps the butter from separating too quickly. All right, we're gonna add the rest of our butter in there. Now, you know what, that's a good amount of butter. We'll just melt those last three in, and then I'll reserve these off to the side. Clean off the cutting board so we can plate up, guys. So let's wash off the knife. I'm gonna do a daisy cam right at the end, guys.
because I just want to get this plated up while everything's hot. So just bear with me. Got our plates ready to rock, guys. Pop's coming through with another 1,000 biddies. Thanks so much, Dad. Appreciate that, man. Thank you. All right, guys, we're just about ready to rock and roll. We're gonna strain our sauce out real quick. Strain our sauce out. To a bowl. You guys gotta see the color of this, man. Wait till you see the color of the sauce on the plate, guys. It's so bomb. Here, we'll strain it on the camera so you guys can see it. It's got such a nice tint to it. All right. We're ready to plate up, ladies and gentlemen. We have delicious Bruges sauce right here. Silky smooth, exactly, Pops. All right, so. The reason I moved the camera down here was mainly for the plate up. You guys ready to plate up? Huh? Who's here ready for the plate up? Let me see them Cousin Drew emotes in chat right now if you're ready to plate up. Alright. Everything off. Let's do this. So how I'm envisioning this plate is... Let's see. This is what I got envisioned. So, I'm going to go ahead and put some of you down. Yam down. Again, we're gonna grab our cabbage. It's hot as a mofo. Grab the bread. Alright, so we're gonna grab some of our cabbage here. You guys see what I'm working with here? What I had in mind? The sauce is gonna go around this on the outside. Keep this nice and tucked. Alright, a little bit more cabbage down, guys. You guys feel me? Okay. Alright, just bear with me, guys. This one will take me just a sec. There we go. Okay, cabbage is down. Next, we'll do our fish down.
Make sure we're neatly tucked here. All right, let's grab our fish fillets. Get our fish back. All right, one. Let's get number two down. Perfect. And then the fook got all sorts of bleedage over there. Now let's get our delicious sauce. Oh my goodness gracious. Janelle coming through with the raid with 33 others. Are you serious? Oh my gosh. What's going on, Janelle? Welcome, everybody. Welcome, welcome. Thank you so much, guys, for stopping by. You came right in time for the plate up of tonight's episode. Welcome, everybody. Everyone in the family tree, go ahead and welcome all of Janelle's guests that she brought into the stream. What's going on, Janelle? Thank you so much for bringing everybody by. I'll explain what we have here right after I drop the sauce down. Gonna kindly wrap our sauce around the plate here. Welcome everybody, welcome, welcome, welcome from Janelle's stream. Alright. We got our sauce down. Let's get plate number two. I will explain exactly what we got on the plate for you guys in just a second. Just about done with our plate up. Alright, 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 guys. Here we are. Thank you so much, guys. Thanks for stopping by. Potsy TV and Stimpier, thank you so much for the follows, guys. Welcome, everybody. Like I said, thank you again, Janelle, for the raid. I appreciate it. Hope you guys had a great night in Janelle's stream. Saw you were baking spotted dick, the English baking thing. So what we have tonight for you guys is a pistachio crusted halibut served with a sweet white yam mash with our braised red cabbage and a Bruges butter sauce, right? How's that look, guys? Looking good, huh? So that's the dish for tonight, guys. Looking bomb diggity. I'm ready to dig into this, huh? Caught in just in time. You aren't going to eat it on cam? I can eat on cam with you guys. That's no problem, Burson. I'll go ahead and eat on cam with you. Drew said dick. It's spotted dick. Watching this stream while eating McDonald's is legit depressing. That's hilarious. Yeah, I'm drinking wine straight out the bottle. I'm not so much of a classy broad, right? So here we go. We got our dish. I'm going to leave this on for you guys real quick to glare at. I'm going to go ahead and bring Kaylee up her dish. I want her to enjoy it while it's hot. And while she does so, I'm going to be right back and we'll go ahead and taste it on camera together with you guys. And I'm going to go ahead and bring Daisy on back with me, guys. So just stick around. A treat? All right, guys, we got our Daisy girl back out. Come here, baby. All right, let's go ahead and rotate over for you guys. Come here, baby. Say hi. Sit. Until we get our Daisy cam fixed, this is what we're going to be working with, guys. Sorry. All right. Shake. Good girl. Say hi to everybody. Say hi to all our newcomers. Hey, what's this? Say hi to everybody.
is the Daisy girl. Hey. We have a high five? Oh, yeah. Yeah, she's a sleepy girl. She was just in bed. I took her on a nice run today, so she's a little bit worn out. Huh, sweet girl. Hey. Say hi, all right? You want to go back to bed? Go ahead, sweetie. You can go back. Go ahead. All right, let's get you back on our dish, guys. So that was the Daisy girl. What? Where's the halibut? Where's the dog's plate? Right? She don't get none of this tonight. So here's our dish, guys. Let's go ahead and eat together tonight, all right? Just cooking for the halibut, huh? Just cooking for the halibut. I hot Asian girl. Thank you so much for the follow. Dead Draw Todd. Thank you very much for the follow. So let's go ahead and dig in, guys. I do need to take a picture. Thank God I said that. The last time I did this and I ate at the cutting board, I completely forgot to take a picture. So let me knock a picture out real quick, guys. Alright, we got plenty of pictures, huh? Alright guys, let's go ahead and dig into the dish. Super excited. So first and foremost, taste the sauce. Nice and velvety and buttery. Let's taste our cabbage. You definitely get that five spice, baby. It's got a pungent taste, I like it. Mm-hmm. Kaylee won't like the cabbage. She doesn't like coleslaw, so I don't expect her to like the cabbage, that's for damn sure. But she'll like the white yam. So I'm gonna move the halibut to the side. Cause this white yams, guys, I'm telling you, white yams as a mash is one of the best things I've ever tried. This is the first time I've done it. Absolutely incredible. Oh my gosh. I'm encouraging all of you guys to go get some white yams, cook them down in some water till they're fork tender, throw them in the mixer with some butter, some heavy whipping cream, garlic, salt, pepper, a little bit of ground allspice, and some maple syrup, and you're gonna have one of the most delicious mashes you've ever had. Let's go ahead and dig into our halibut. It flaked apart absolutely perfectly. Mmm.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Try it in our sauce. Mm-hmm. That pistachio crust. Delicious. So, describe taste. Thanks, Maxie. I appreciate that so much. Describe the taste. So, you get the saltiness from the pistachio right off the bat. That delicious pistachio flavor with the saltiness. The cornmeal adds a nice crunch. The Italian parsley adds freshness. The Dijon mustard is just a delicious taste that's sitting there with that fresh lemon zest in there. Immediately refreshes your palate, right? And then you hit it with that red wine Bruges sauce, and it's just absolutely perfect together. A little bit pungent, a little bit acidic, right? Absolutely great. Delicious. These yams are perfectly sweetened. They're perfectly mashed and whipped. I think they got the perfect amount of butter in them. I'm really, really happy with the way these turned out. I could eat this all day long. The cabbage is very pungent. The saltiness of the bacon in there kind of mellows it out. But the pungent, acidic taste from the red wine and vinegar is definitely there. So if you're into acidic, this is the thing that you're going to like. I can't see your name. It's in black. Jesse Rivel, River. Can't see it. It's so dark. Is the yam stuff like a turnip mash? Yeah, it's kind of like a turnip mash. You just chop it up, throw it in some water, and cook it down until it's fork tender. And then whip it. I got a rack of baby back ribs I'm going to be putting in the smoker.
Got any pro tips? Hey, Maxie, or anybody in chat, or you know what? You can go ahead and do it yourself, Potsy. You want to go ahead and click exclamation dry rub? Why don't I do it for you? We got a little command. And if you want to rub your ribs down with this, go ahead and rub your ribs down with this little dry rub. That's the CousinDrew's dry rub. And I'm telling you, your ribs are going to come out that much better. All right, Janelle, thanks so much for stopping by. I appreciate the raid. Thank you so much. Have a good rest of your night. I really appreciate the raid a lot. Thank you so much. Hope that cake turned out good. I didn't get to see the end of it. And thanks so much again for the raid. Seriously, it's incredible, Janelle. Thank you. You're too kind. Potsy, use that dry rub. Put it on the ribs, both sides. Meat side, obviously, the most. Let it sit in the fridge with the dry rub on it for like 24 hours before you go ahead and cook it off. I'm telling you. I'm telling you. It's the way to go. It really, really is. Man, this is delicious. So look, guys, thank you so much for stopping by. I've said it before, and I'm going to say it again. I got to go do the whole run through again with all you newcomers here. Every Tuesday and Thursday, your boy's going to be live. Thursday night, we're doing fried chicken. I'm excited. I haven't done my fried chicken with you guys, so we're doing fried chicken bone-in. All right? So be back Thursday at 7 p.m. Hit your boy up on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. I got all the HD pictures of all the dishes uploaded on there for you guys in way better resolution than you're looking at right now. We got the top of the line camera we're taking the pictures with, right? Looking real good on the website. Hit www.cousindrewscookingshow.com. You can watch live from the website, and you can also email me, contact me through the website as well. We got pictures of the food up on there and a little bit of an about me on there as well if you guys want to learn a little bit more about the kid. Hit that follow button if you guys are having a good time. If you guys have a Twitch Prime available, we're doing a subscriber giveaway next week on Tuesday. Got a workout. I will release on Thursday what I'm giving away. I'm going to go buy it tomorrow. Me and Kaylee are going to make a little home goods trip, pick out something for the subscriber giveaway. So if you guys are interested and you got a Twitch Prime available, or you're enjoying your time, you want to sub to your boy, go right ahead and you can be a part of the subscriber giveaway. You know what I'm saying? Jackie coming through with a 6-month resub. It trips me out seeing the 6-month resub. I can't believe we're already at 6 months, guys. Absolutely unbelievable. S Eddie 33 coming through with a follow. Thank you so much, Eddie. I appreciate that. I know you'd like your home goods runs. I gotta keep eating this though. Well, it's hot. At the bottom of the channel, guys, in the About Me section, if you're on a desktop or laptop, you can scroll down. If you're on a mobile device, you got to go to the About Me into the section. We do have, right underneath the Bit leaderboard, we have a suggestion box. Anything you guys may have to suggest for the stream, please go right ahead, drop a suggestion, whether it's a meal, whether it's a protein, whether it's a side dish, a vegetable, whatever it is, drop it in there, guys. Please, I'd love to cook something you like to see, right? We're always doing suggestions. Jesse Rip, thank you so much for stopping by. I'm glad you enjoyed your time, brother. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed your time, man. Go ahead and give the channel a follow if you like. See you on Thursday if you have some free time. We'll be right back here cooking up some fried chicken. Thanks so much, guys, again, for stopping by. I appreciate it. Thanks all you guys from Janelle and Chase Raids. We got 2 raids tonight. Tremendous amount of support from you guys. All the bits, absolutely unbelievable. Thank you so much, guys, seriously. Absolutely outrageous. Thank you for the follows, Jesse. Thank you so much. Unbelievable. I'm going to go ahead and get out of here, guys. I got to finish this up. I got this huge mess to clean up. So you know what, guys? I'll see you on Thursday night at 7 p.m. Please hit up the social medias. Check out the YouTube, guys. We got all past 43 episodes on the YouTube. This will be up by tonight, within the next couple hours, for you guys to check out if you missed the beginning. But check into the YouTube, subscribe to your boy, and I'll see you guys on Thursday. Thanks so much again for stopping by, guys. I appreciate it. It's great being back after a couple weeks. It's great being back in action with you guys. Thanks for all the support. I love each and every one of you guys. All you newcomers, thanks for sticking around. I hope to see you guys all on Thursday night. See you then, guys. Thank you.
Hotline Bling, I see you in there. Thanks for coming by. I see you. I'll see you on Thursday, Hotline. Hope you have a great rest of your night. Moshian, thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate it.